The Fundacion Atapuerca in the north of Spain is the body that governs the archaeology and research that goes on in the Sierra de Atapuerca. The site became particularly famous in the early 1990s when pre-Neanderthal fossils were found in the area and officially became a World Heritage Site in the year 2000.
In some ways, if you look at the Iberian Peninsula, there are only two sites covering that, Atapuerca and Gorham's cave. And Atapuerca covers, if you like, the early part of the story, the human story, and we cover the later part of the human story. So, in addition to agreeing to formalise the collaboration, it's just a framework that says that we share experiences and expertise. We also felt that there was a need for these key places in the world with this recognition by UNESCO to work together in all fields. It's not just about science or research. It could be tourism management of the sites. It could be all kinds of conservation. Somebody may have a specialist in something or another. And we felt we wanted to do this. So that's essentially what happened. I mean, it's born out of people who've known each other for some time, and the fact that we got this huge recognition now was almost the right moment to do this.
And the museum are seemingly intent for this kind of exchange of knowledge and information to be just the start of an ongoing process, with more collaborative work on the horizon.
Our idea for the network is that it goes beyond this. We had people here from Mount Carmel in Israel, which is another World Heritage Site, and we're certainly going to talk to them and the other World Heritage Sites. But our idea is that perhaps, even if it comes to things like projects seeking funding for things like this, if it's two or three of you and you're all World Heritage Sites, then the chances of success are going to be even better than it's just one. One of the things that we want to do as part of the UNESCO family now is contribute as well. And contribute what we do to other sites. So I think that this kind of collaboration is a very good start, but I think also that one of the things that we would want to do as a network is also contribute to other sites that are not on the World Heritage List that may want to come forward, or sites that may be in countries with fewer resources in other parts of the world where we might be able to help to create a greater network of.
And there was more reason for the Gibraltar Museum to celebrate after their short film based on Gorham's cave came away with an award at the Twickenham Alive Film Festival.
The film was made to commemorate the installation of the site as a World Heritage Site. And it was a 5-minute film, and then it was suggested to us that we might want to enter it into the festival. Little did we know that we were going to actually win an award for it. But it really, what it does is it gives a very brief overview. It's a very short film, but it gives a nice overview of what the World Heritage Site is. It's not just the Gorham's Cave complex. It goes all the way to the summit of the rock.
So a vibrant period indeed for the museum, with awards arriving from abroad and exciting networks forming closer to home, with the possibility of even more further afield, as our rock's rich history continues to get the recognition it deserves.